see if I can do this.
There you go.
That looks
you it. Got it. See how perfect that was?
You got a steady hand. Wow, haven't heard this version in a long time, huh?
It's been about 20 years for me.
Yeah.
It's so different.
Wow. So, 1982. Grant Avenue Studios in Hamilton.
That's right.
Incredible, huh? And that's what a lot of people don't know. Remember the bed tracks were done by Daniel Lanois.
That's right.
And he was supposed to be the engineer for this record, remember? But he got a call to go work with a little small band in Ireland, which ended up being U2. So we ended up doing the rest of the record with Stacey.
Well, he owned the studio, right?
He actually owned
the studio in Hamilton, Ontario.
That's
you mentioned.
But then he took off and left us with Stacey. We finished the record, whatever, it was great. But this song, remember when it came out? It was a hit for us in the early 80s. And then,
that's right.
It
went to number 61 on Billboard. Is that right?
That's right.
61
yeah.
on Billboard, and then it went down.
Yeah, and then everything ended for us because punk rock came out and new wave and
skinny tie
band. We're out of a job, so we became couriers. And while we
the reason we became couriers was you and I purchased our own recording studio.
We did,
and we had to pay it off somehow.
Yeah. So we worked at the courier thing for, 4 years? And that was a rough thing because, you know, you would deliver a parcel. I don't know if it happened to you, but it happened to me many times. You'd deliver a parcel and the song's playing on the radio and you'd say, hey, that's my band, that's me on the radio. And they'd go, yeah, right, get out. You know, remember that?
But then when it did become, it somehow got out there that we were couriers and CBC was trying to chase us.
Well, this is after, though. Before that happened, we got a call from Dean Cameron, right? You were talking about
the second time
it became a hit. So, we got a call from, we were working on the Alias album. Well, it wasn't Alias, we were just working on tracks. Remember we got a call from Dean saying, you guys are going to have a hit.
And we both got a call. I remember, Fred, do you realize you have a number one record?
Yeah, what are you talking about?
Our album's not out yet.
Yeah, so we went up to the Capitol Records, and we walked into the boardroom and there was like balloons and congratulations and all that stuff. And we're like, what's going on? So that DJ in Vegas had re-released it. And it went up to number
Smith?
One.
Jay,
it'll come to me, hang on.
Good, your memory's better than mine.
But so it went to number one. And here we are, we're couriers with a number one song on Billboard in America. Something wrong with that picture, right?
So. It didn't go number one in Canada, did it, again? It went number one the first time.
That's right.
In the early 80s, but it didn't go number one the second time.
Yeah. And hey, here's the note, but this is different on this version.
The album version is a single version.
Yeah.
I re-sang it.
That's right. For the remix.
That's right, for the remix,
single
for the
mix.
Single. Yeah.
And because you didn't know where the end was.
I just kept singing.
You just kept singing, and Stacey was supposed to fade you out. He never faded you out.
And he kept it.
So here it is. Still pretty long.
Yeah. That's when I was a youngin'.
That's right. Wow. Incredible, huh?
This is the first time, I've got to say, I've heard True on vinyl for must be 20, 30 years or something like that.
Yeah, it is, but doesn't it takes me straight back to the thrill of taking that record home to my mum and dad and putting it on the record player.
There's a heavy guitar that I hated heavy guitar at the time, but Kevin asked me to play through a Marshall, and then he wanted a Les Paul, so they actually borrowed a Les Paul that Keith Richards had left behind.
No way. Fantastic.
Yeah.
So you got to play Keith Richards' guitar in this. Is that for the power chords?
Yeah.